Closing talk, Hacker Hotel 2018. Thank you all for being here. Before I start to improvise on my closing talk, I have some stuff that I will do first, because else I forget. I already forgot in the opening talk to mention ETH0. It will be in 1 month, so I'll take this stage now to make some promotion for them. If you like this and you've never been to Hacker Hotel, then there's a similar event like this in the nice capital of Leeuwarden. You can sleep in a jail, an actual jail. It's Blokhuis Poort jail. It's been converted partly into a hotel. The Hackerspace is there, Freck, and they will have their event. So if you didn't buy your tickets yet and you like this, hacking, friends, having fun, then go to ETH0. If you think this is a bit informal, or you had expected maybe even more technical talks — we had technical talks, but if you wanted only technical talks — then there is another alternative in November, if I'm correct. It's called TDOS, the Technical Dutch Open Source Event, and you can go there. It's very nice, I've been told, so I'll still check it out myself as well. But if you're really into technical stuff and you like an event, then go to TDOS. Then the last of my, before my improvisation starts, I received two of these nice phases, which I printed with the RepRap filament. I always go to this first Thursday of the month. They have a print and pizza night. So if you're into 3D printing or want to learn it or have questions, you can go to RepRap World and they have a print and pizza night. It's really fun. I always go there or try to be there. I have two phases. I took the liberty to take this one for my girlfriend, since she has to put up with me. So this one is gone, and this one is for the person that can come up with the funniest name for this thing. So that's why I say it now. You can all think about it. People that want to leave in the end can leave. And if you have a very nice name for this printed vase, then think about it. Let it sink in, and in the end we'll do a round and probably have an applaudometer or something. If you shout the loudest as the funniest name, we will give it to that person or something. I don't know, I'm just improvising. So, well then, for Hacker Hotel, first event in Westcourt Hotel de Veluwe. Some of you already knew, but some don't. I already signed the contract for next year. Next year will be 15th until the 17th of February in this same spot. If we book more than 80 rooms, we have 66 now, so it's a small increase of just 14 rooms. So if everybody brings a friend, it's done. So then with 80 rooms in total, then we'll have the complete hotel, all the rooms. So you have a separate room for lockpicking, you have a racetrack dedication for the whole weekend, a dedicated racetrack. You can have your own hall if you want to, I don't know, massage people or whatever you want to do. It's possible. We have all the rooms, but we need to have the 80 rooms. So if you have the money and can spare it, or until the 1st of June, please do so. I have all the ticket prices at the same level as they were this year. After the 1st of June, the price will rise. So get your tickets soon. Okay, in conclusion of the event, I hope you all liked it.
Yay!
Okay. Okay. I hope you all liked it.
Yeah.
Okay. That's more like it. Thank you so much. I would like to thank the sponsors, because without the sponsors it wasn't even possible. We have helped people getting into Hacker Hotel, or awarded them for their efforts. People really helped a lot. As I said in my opening talk, I would like to formalize this a bit more. So if you think you can contribute to this event by doing something, even if it's just one afternoon making a nice schedule in a form which I like, then you're more than welcome to do that. If you can help me other ways, just let me know. Would love that. But without the sponsors, there wasn't an event like this. So I'd like to thank Guardian 360 for being the main sponsor of this event. Thank you guys, without you it wasn't possible. You all found your Coke Zero cans. There was a reason. The Cybersprint logo is black and red. So therefore, Cybersprint offered you these cans, those pens, the beer coasters on the bar. So Cybersprint, thank you as well. Then there are people from that company here. Schuberg Willis, they generously donated money, and I'd like to thank them for that. Thank you for making it possible, Schuberg Willis. And then S-Unit, Barry, thank you very much for your donation for Hacker Hotel, the S-Unit. Give it up for the S-Unit. We're almost there. She's already here. You saw her in Jos's talk. Astrid Ozenbrug, thank you so much for your sponsoring from Ozenbrug Advies. So thank you so much. And then there's just one left. All these lights you see around her, the desk, the mixer, all the stuff has been supplied by Steven Gits of Fox IT Event Productions. Fox it. So, I heard it over the weekend a lot. Is this a joke? Fox it? No, seriously. Fox IT, no, there's no connection. Steven founded this company years ago. He didn't hear of Fox IT then. So, to clear this up for once and for all, it's Fox it Event Productions. And I hope you all remember, and if you ever have a Hacker Hotel or you have something other like this, call Fox it, Steven. So thank you so much, Fox it, for all the nice equipment. Hey. So yeah.
However, I would like to just interrupt you for a small second. Of course, okay. All the sponsors are wonderful and very nice, and we very much thank them. However, there is one person who would not, who we need to thank, who would have made this whole thing completely impossible. So, no, not Anne-Jan. that is clearly you, right? And before you clap, more than a deserved welcome to Dimitri. It is good to spend a few minutes just kind of reflect on what has happened the last weekend. Lack of sleep has happened quite copiously.
Agree.
Lack of mate has happened almost.
No, almost.
No, almost. There's mate almost, but so right. A lot of weirdness, right? Destruction for science, creation for science, creation for the lulz, everything.
Igor, so there's a microphone.
There's a microphone. Yeah, but it is Philip.
Now we can hear.
So the people who were involved and people who were trying to do things were thinking, well, we need to somehow thank you. So how do we thank you in a way that represents what Hacker Hotel is? So lack of sleep you already have, so that's we don't need to add that.
Agree.
So we thought, well, okay, so what does Hacker Hotel mean? Well, it means doing really strange combinations of things. We had 3D printing, we had electronics, there was little carts running around, there's iron burning, metals being beaten, there is security being done. So it's kind of diverse. It's also never finished. It's a process, yeah. Right? It's a thing that happens and then happens again and then maybe never happens, but of course happens again. Maybe the batteries run out, so you need a second set of batteries. And so we thought, well, how do we bring all of that stuff together for you? So I would like you to hold this for a second so I have my hands free. So what happened here is that caffeine fueled discussion started around the 3D printers. Like, wow, you can print these cool things. Mm-hmm. He has this logo, he likes lasers. Oh, that's pretty cool. And we have some metals. And oh, so if you start combining things, something like this happens. We have for you spare batteries, because batteries run out. We have the Hacker Hotel logo.
Right? Oh,
we
wow.
have molten cans from BitLayer. So thank wow. you, BitLayer, for donating bits of aluminium. We have LEDs, so Anion, thank you very much for the random LEDs and the badge team who has created wonderful charging circuits and Velcro. The back of this thing is still being printed because, of course, a Hacker Hotel is never finished. So,
good one.
We'll come back with the, so you still have spare parts.
Holy crap.
And we hope this reminds you of the wonderful event you have. And please, all of you, let's thank Dimitri. Give it up.
Wow. Thank you so much, man. It's really we'll means a lot.
Till the next year.
Wow. Wow. Yep. This is cool. This is awesome. It's really aluminium.
It should should be worth saying that that Igor almost destroyed his first first flower pot trying to cast that in iron at about 3,000 degrees. So we recast it in aluminum. So there was several attempts on that, and several of us were witnesses to that process today. And Igor has Michelle have some new fans for having done such an incredible job as well. So
thank you all, guys. Really, really, really awesome. This will get a special place in my house. So when you visit me, you will see this for sure. Okay, in ending then, as said again, without sponsors, it wouldn't be possible. Well, clearly, probably me then. I understand now. So thank you so much for that. But also, I would like to thank you all for being here. I hope I can see you all next year. Bring a friend, bring colleagues, tell your boss, whatever. Let's make this even bigger and better. But I'm very happy how this edition went. I think it's the best so far. So thank you all. See you next year.
Face.
And now the face. So, if you think you have a funny name, just good one. I think you can do better. Just come up here if you have a funny name. And we just, if you don't want to join, and then you, the guys that don't, come. No, I'll bring them up. Oh, yeah. Come on. If you have a funny name for this face, you can win this face. So come up in the front here. If you like something.
You sit here.
Yeah. Or maybe on this line then. On the line.
You can it.
Okay. Dankjewel, man. See ya. Okay. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 contestants. You are the newly invented applaudometer. I just thought this up. So Buck will say his funny name. Then you can just no.
No,
that would be fair.
We are measuring the loudness, not your opinion.
Let it sink in. Let's hear all the names. Think for yourself who you like the most. And then when we go one by one, you can clap at one person and really loud and make a lot of noise. So the loudest noise wins this fast. So Buglu, what is your name for this colorful face?
Yeah, somebody has to do it, so Cyber.
Cyber. No, wait. Think of the name. Now Jos, what's your name for this?
It is een Wraas.
Een Wraas.
Wraas.
Oké.
A cyber butt plug.
A cyber butt plug, oké. Okay. Mandy, what's your name for this contraption?
3D printed face thingy.
3D printed face thingy. Hold it. Would it fit in your new house?
Yes.
Okay, oh, I'm not influencing the public here. So, Jeroen, last but not least.
To be honest, Aglaes.
Aglaes. Okay, now, for Brooke's name, the cyber.
Cyber!
Thank you.
That's pretty long off. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much. And now, Jos.
Een Wraas.
Okay, here we go.
Cyber butt plug.
Okay, I think that's the loudest until now, so.
The 3D printed face thingy. For my new home.
Okay, and now Jeroen's.
The Aglaes.
Now. From this vantage point, it sounded that Mandy won the farce. Am I correct? Here you go. Congratulations. I hope it fits in your new house. Okay. Mandy, give it up for Mandy. Okay. Oh,
it's about this.
What? Just in time production, guys. 3D printing is the future. Mr. Vermeen has a book about this. It's really awesome. You should all read it. He wrote it with a 3D printer expert. So, but 3D printing is the future. That's the name of his book. Mr. Vermeen, you can look him up. He does something with books. So, just in time. Thank you all. See you next year.